So hello and welcome to a new video on our 45 Unplugged channel. My name is Jan. I'm a 45 presets consultant for the DACH region. And today's topic is the WebInspect automation. So let's begin with the goal of today's video. This is to create a script that start and run a dynamic scan using 45 WebInspect and upload the results into our software security center, and that completely automated. So to do that, we need first to define these steps that need to be in our script. So the first step is the actual start of our dynamic scan using 45 WebInspect. After that, we just wait until the scan is finished and download the results locally to our machine. And the last step is just to upload these results to our software security center. And to do that, I prepared a structure. So first of all, we have our CI/CD server. If you want, you can also use a slave or agent, but it's not necessary. And we also need our 45 WebInspect API as well as the software security center. And now I can show you the different steps in the structure here. So first of all, we need our CI/CD server or the slave or agent to start the scan and just wait for the status change on the 45 WebInspect API and download the results locally to our slave or agent, for example. And after that, we need to upload the results from the slave or agent to the software security center. But let me show you that in my script. So now we are in my script. This is written in PowerShell, especially for PowerShell 7. So if you want to use it, make sure you already upgrade PowerShell to version 7. And just to explain you what is inside of here. So the script starts with some variables that we need, and that are very basic stuff like the WebInspect API URL. In this case, it's just an IP address. And then we need our SSC URL and our application version ID to just let the script know where the upload should be. So I will show you that in a second, but we also need our SSC token to upload the results. But to show you where you can get the application version ID and the SSC token, I now switch to the software security center that I'm using. And for that application version ID, we only need to go to applications. Now select our application that we want to use. In my case, it's the Zero Web App Security application, and go to the URL, because here is the application version number. This is number 6. So you can also see that here are no scan results, just to show you the current status. And for the token, you only need to go to administration, to users, token management, and create a new token. Very important here is that you need to use a unified login token. And let's enter a description and click on save. So here is the token that we need in our script. So let just this one copy and enter it here. Okay, great. The next variables that we need are the variables for the actual dynamic scan. So of course we need to say the script what website we want to scan. So there's a variable called scan URL. And in this case, we are scanning the zero.webappsecurity.com website. This is a micro focus website to actually test 45 WebInspect. And after that, we need to define crawl and audit mode. In this case, we using crawl and audit, and we also need to add and scan name. So that are only the required settings for the scan configuration, but you can also add some other different things like a local macro or proxy. But you can also have a look at your WebInspect API in the Swagger interface. You only need to go to Scanner and create a new scan. And there is the whole documentation about what parameters can be inside of this scan settings. So you can see here is a proxy, for example. So if you want to add something, this is completely, you can also add some other things. But let's switch back to the script. The other important thing before we can actually start with the different steps that we defined before is the API authentication, because in my example, I'm using a basic authentication on my WebInspect API, and for that, we need to create some credentials that we're using in our API calls. But now we can start with the different steps. So the first one is actually run the scan. And for that, you need to create a body with all the informations about the scan that you want to make with all the scan settings. And after that, you can actually call the API to start the scan. And after we do that, we get a response back from the API server. And that is the scan ID. And that is very important that we store this unique scan ID into a file, or in this case, into a variable, that we can use it later for the download of the results. But first, we need to check if the current status of the scan is changing. And for that, I created a do while loop where the do while loop just asking the API every 20 seconds in this case for the current status and just have a look at the response. And if the response is scan completed, scan stopped, or scan interrupted, it will do the next steps. So after that, there is an if statement. So if the scan status is completed, there is also another log information, and we can start with the export of the scan to our local machine. So for that, we are also using our scan ID here and downloading the FPR, so the 45 project results file, to our local server. In this case, it's the CI/CD server, or an agent, or a slave. And last but not least is the upload to our SSC. And for that, we need to use a special SSC header, because we need to authenticate using the SSC token. And after that, we can use our file that we already downloaded and uploaded into the Software Security Center. But let me just start the script, and I see you in a second. So welcome back to our script and also the log. So it seems like everything was successfully. You can see here that the log files are also there. So there is log information that the scan is completed. Also anything about the download of the results file and the upload into SSC. So with that, let's have a look at our SSC. So I will switch back to our application, our Zero Web App Security application, and ta-da, we can see all our results here. If we have a look at the artifacts, we can also see that this was uploaded by us. And yeah, now we are able to actually see all our vulnerabilities inside of here. So that is the one option that you can do to run it locally, but you can, as I said, also put it inside of an CI/CD pipeline. And for that, we can switch to Azure DevOps. So this is also just my example environment. So So we go inside of our Xero web app and into our pipelines. I already created a pipeline, but I only add a task with the PowerShell script here. So there's nothing in here. In this case, I select the inline. And now I can just copy paste the whole script in here. The only thing that you need to make sure is under advanced that the PowerShell core is selected, because we are using PowerShell 7 in that case. And after that, we can save and queue the whole script and see what happened inside of the logs. So now we can see that our script is loading, and hopefully it will start soon. Yeah, right. Okay, so now we can see the same like in the script on the local machine. So here is the scan ID, and the scan is now started. Great. Okay, so let's switch back to our presentation. So just the last slide where I want to explain you a little bit more about the benefits about the script. That is first, of course, the complete automation of DAST scan into your CI/CD pipeline, including the upload into the Software Security Center. And the cool thing about that is yet that you don't need any requirements. So you don't need to install WebInspect on your CI/CD server or your slave or any other tools. So the only thing that you need is, in this case, PowerShell 7. But that's very easy and sometimes already on the machine. So you don't need any other extra requirements. And with that, it's also platform independent. That means you can easily translate the whole script into Python script if you want, or Bash script. So that's completely up to you. And it's also completely up to you what you want to put inside of the script. So I showed you an example with very basic scan, but you can also add some extra things like a logger macro or a proxy or whatever you want, and just create your own script. And with that, I want to say thank you for attending the video. And my name is Jan. If you want to contact me via mail or just LinkedIn, that would be great. And if you have any comment on the video, just comment below. So thanks a lot. Have a nice day.